direction.
Now, when you take Facebook, I have the highest Facebook likes in Ghana. Last 2 weeks, I just crossed 3 million likes. Now, right now it's like 3,030,000. I don't wake up every morning and I see I have 3 million likes, and so what? I ask myself, how am I going to convert that 3 million likes into money? I want to convert it into money. So certain companies have now started approaching, okay, John, let's put our commercials on your page. Because if I put my commercial on your page, relatively 1.5 or 1 million Ghanaian people will see it, which is higher than television, which is higher than radio. So I'm thinking about innovative ways to make money. But as an actor, when you wake up, like I tell my other colleague actors and actors, you have to think outside the box. Social media has become very powerful. People in America just get up and become billionaires because they post stupid YouTube videos and everybody say, but YouTube will pay you for advertising on your video and you can make money. You have Snapchat now. How many of you are on Snapchat? You have Snapchat, you have Instagram. But you ask yourself, how is that making you money? How are you? Everybody has 24 hours in a day. If you close your eyes for 1 minute, you lost 1 minute. You lost 60 seconds. How did that impact your life? You understand? How did that impact your life? Every journey I take right now, I'm always like what you're saying. I came to tsunami, when I was coming to tsunami, already my truck had been with tsunami did that. Because when I finish from here, I'm going to sit on my friend D. And say, please, I want family. Do you have some? Then I've established a relationship because I came here. At least they paid for my transport here. So I'm using that to do back movement. I'm justifying why I am here. So because of that, I don't want to go back to Accra and come back later on and say that, okay, I'm buying petrol again to come to Tsunami. Because I want to. Every journey I take or every step I take, I ask myself, is it justified? You have to be able to be a brand. Bill, right now, I can say that most of the income that I get is not really from acting. It is from endorsements, it is from events. Every month, I get called for an event, let's say around the world. Next month, I'll be in Australia. In December, I'll be in... Next month, in December, I'll be in Miami and in Kenya. In Kenya, I'm going to talk, like, you know, there's an entrepreneurial camp. So it's like every month, I am somewhere. But that's because I decided that I'm not going to act forever. I have to start choosing a channel or a branch from the acting that I can make money for. You look at someone like 50 Cent. When was the last time you heard his new song? In chair, but he's rich. He's doing boxing promotion, he's doing so many things. Look at Puff Daddy. The last one of the last time he heard a song from him, but he's doing so many things right now. Look at this, one of the last time. You have to be able to identify the talent and ask yourself, what exactly are you going to use that talent for to make money? I'm all about money. I'm sorry, that's why we are here. Because of money. If they send short school right now, they'll pay you 50,000 a week. You should. Fast. Most of my books will be 10-5.
Oh, Patrick. It's been innovative ways of making money. They identify a problem. Most entrepreneurs in the world, then you can make money. Say that, look, when I finish school, this is what I want to do. I want to do A, B, C, D. This is my plan. This is what it is. And a lot of people, even your wife.
My
mama.
Before I came here, I thought about writing a book. Because I like writing. If you go on my Instagram and Facebook, you know sometimes they write some motivational things. When I said that, that's why I was like, ah, this thing I'm writing, I'm putting it on Facebook. Instagram, people read it, they say, how am I making money out of it? That's why God has brought me here today to meet this man to write a book for me. And that's how I make money. And that's how I make money. Because I see it as, when you make money, you should be able, you are creating employment. And don't forget to also give money. Charity is the way forward. You have to be able, look, there's no wrong in it. You literally give me somebody 10 cents or 20 cents because the person needs help. I do a lot of charity work in Ghana, yeah. Forget I said it. But there's no harm in giving out. I do a lot of charity work. I do it not because I'm sure. I do it because maybe I'll say God, not maybe. God has blessed me and I'm just giving back. Sometimes I get broke. Do you know what I do when I get broke? I'll buy, and this is big. I can't see anything. Okay. I'll buy credit. I'll buy petrol. Then I'll just go and sit in my house and watch YouTube. Then I know I'm broke. Because those are the essential things in life. But when I buy the credit, it's because I'm making calls to know my next move or to do something. And always I'm being forced in mind. At the end of the day, you have to believe in yourself. You have to know your potential. Don't fear failure. Failure makes you stronger. I've done so many businesses and failed that. Right now, somebody's asking me, I can tell you, Charlie, that business, if you do A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, this is the experience you get. School is not going to give you experience. Business will give you experience. Failure will give you experience. Because at the end of the day, you know that if you are doing mobile money, people will say, okay, how many of you have thought about mobile money as making money? Like setting up a mobile money business? Only one person. Here's the thing, when I was driving from Kumasi to Tsunami, there are so many towns along the way. You have Tumuko, you have Doya, you have all those things. Maha. All those places. Because this is an informal way of saving money. You have to think of certain solutions to make money. Don't be afraid to put your hand in the dirt. Don't be afraid to say, okay, because I've got a university degree, I can't go and make me go again in one chain. Everybody needs good to it. You understand? Everybody needs good to it. So if you do good business, you make money. The same way if you work at Beaumont, you make money. But Beaumont was started, you didn't need Beaumont representative there. No. Where? You. And us. You want to start by one person. Why can't you also be your own? Why can't you start something? But you just have to be able to start small. One thing, don't be a local champion. People refuse to grow. Chatawale. Don't be a local champion. Don't think that you go somewhere and maybe you are this, and at the end of it, you have to be able to think outside the box. Because right now, as I'm here, when I go to Kenya, people watch films there. They'll know me, oh, Joe, hey. But when I see them, I ask myself, how will I make my money? No, wait. They mention your name, how am I making money? So you create a product, like I have the clothing line. A lot of people ask me, oh, if I bought 20 here, I'm sure a lot of people buy it. Am I right? Yes. That's it. So you don't have to be a local champion. Think outside the box. Africa is big. You can make so much money. We are here, foreigners come into the country, they make money. Why can't we make the money ourselves? You understand my point? Why not? There's a technology boom. A lot of people are doing apps, a lot of people are doing all those things. Snapchat, Facebook, all those things was just started by one person. You can be that person. Nothing should limit you. Nothing should stop you. You can be who you are and get to where you want to. And remember, you have to dream big. Let your passion wake you up in the morning. Let me tell you, when I'm going to bed, I get sad. You know why? Because I normally go to bed around 12 or 1. When I'm going to bed, I get sad because I can't wait for the morning to come for me to start or to continue where I left off. Let passion wake you up and let success put you to sleep. If you don't have success, don't sleep. You have to read a lot. I'm on the internet most of the time. Not because I'm watching people's faces on Instagram. Okay, maybe I'm watching girls on Instagram and Facebook and this. Because now it's necessary. Identify problems and find solutions to it. There are rich people in Ghana. There are rich people in Sunyani. There are rich people in Kumasi. You can be the next richest person in Ghana and in Africa. It's as simple as that. Thank you very much.
You are one of the actors who faces a lot of challenges, I don't know, ups and downs, a lot of negative comments and other things. I want to ask, how do you handle those comments when it comes? And how do you handle the people around you who always want to bring you down? Thank you.
Please, if you have a business plan as a student, and you have all it takes to establish it, you have to wait till you complete school before you start it, or you can start it as you are.
My name is Doma.
Hi.
I'm business and my dad as you are. How can I make money from you? Because I want my number two. Having a business idea, is it best to share your business ideas with your friends or you need to grow it within you? And when you think you've reached the apex of it, then you can share it out. Thank you.
Okay, I go to church. I have other activities that I do.
I mean, sometimes it's not really the right challenge, it pain, but at the end of the day, I care. The good thing about Ghana media is when they start talking about you, within a week or two, if you don't respond, they will die down. I mean, it is just dead. So let them say whatever, if they are talking about you on campus, let them say whatever, are they talking about you on campus? I sure. You don't hear it yet. You don't hear it. But if they are talking negatively about you, whoever you are, if they are talking negatively about you, don't worry. At the end of the day, it is where you want to be in life that matters. A lot of people will talk about you, but when you look at yourself and you look at them, it's because they wish they had what you had. That's why they are talking about you. If you bought a new car and they say, oh, the sugar daddy bought it for you, or the sugar mommy bought it for you, or you're going to do Sakawa. At the end of the day, who has the car and who doesn't have the car? By the way, Sakawa is bad. But at the end of the day, who has the car and who doesn't have the car? At the end of the day, who's built the house? Who hasn't built the house? Let them see what they want to see. And God will just judge everybody. It's as simple as that. Just when you can start about in school. I mean, Mark, the one who did this, he even dropped out of school. And he started, he's now very rich. Bill Gates, he did the same thing. He dropped out of school. But I'm not saying you drop out of school. But it's best to start now. Whilst you're in school before you finish, because if you say you finish, maybe somebody else would have started an idea or whatever it is. And then, when you want to argue about your friends? The next question. Okay. So, just if you have an idea now, it's better to start now. But remember to think big, start small, but start now. Action. Collabo. I mean, the name is collaborative, and it's fine, it's not a problem. I mean, you can tell your friends, because obviously two heads are better than one. So you can tell the ideas to your friends, but make sure that the ideas that are telling to your friends, they are on the same level as you. Because some of the ideas, when you tell people, they'll be like, how is this one going to tell? This one won't work. Forget it. Don't get it. You understand? We'll just go find some food shop or whatever it is. You have to surround yourself with people who are on the same level as you, people who think like you, people who have the same vision like you. If you surround yourself with people who don't have the same vision like you, at the end of the day, you'll be visionless. There's a saying that goes that if you are the smartest in the room, then you're in the wrong room. At first when I read it, I was like, what kind of life is this? But if you are the smartest in the room, how are you going to grow as a person? If I enter a room right now and there are very brilliant people, there are more brilliant people than me, I'll be happy because I can learn something from them. You always have to learn something from people. At the end of the day, when you become the smartest, yes, you have given lessons to those who are not smart, but you have to always be able to grow yourself, challenge yourself. That's the way. You have to challenge yourself all the time. Don't set goals that you know that challenges one day to be hard to achieve. But at the end of the day, when you achieve it, you set higher goals. Don't let the sky be the limit. Let the sky be the starting place in whatever that you're doing. It's about knowing what you want to do and where you want to go. It's simple. Time management is the best. Look, acting is difficult. I once said, they give you a script. The lines are a lot. You have to put it in your head and act it out. When you see the movie and then they'll say, oh, that's the movie right here, and this, or you think, oh, this one is easy. I can bet you, if I put all of you in front of a camera right now, I'm sure 90% of you will fail. There are so many cuts. Before you get a complete scene, one complete scene, there are so many cuts. Yeah, because you have to say it like this, you have to do this, you have to hold Yvonne Nelson like that, you have to hold Jackie like this, or you have to slap my teeth. Which I don't mind doing. I'll slap him over and over again. But nothing in this world comes easy. Sometimes we fail till early in the morning. By the time you come out of the house or the room, people are going to work. But that's when we finish showing. Then you go and sleep. Then 12, 2 in the afternoon, you go back to film. It's a full-time job. You have to invest in your career. You have to invest in it. I have a film school. Sometimes when people come and they say they want to be actors, I ask you, why do you want to be actors? They say, oh, maybe because I want to be famous, or you want people to see you on television. But have you invested in the craft? As of now, I'm an actor. I'm still investing. I still watch movies to learn. I still watch movies to improve upon myself. Because if I don't improve upon myself, I won't grow. It's as simple as that. I'm challenging myself to get new roles. Because it's not every day that I'll play Lava Boy on the streets and that's it. I have to be commando. I have to be around me. So I'm investing in myself. Pasta.
One day, he came home and he said, Daddy, I want to be like John DeMello. I said, what? See, John DeMello went to Christ again. And I think he passed by and he saw her and he see a small girl, a 9-year-old girl, was in love. But we all know how he ended up. He died as a poor person. There's a video I want to show. The second person is Mike Tyson. He was a very good boxer. He did all that he do in his life, but now we don't even know where.
I'm a technical success, so people sometimes call me a motivational speaker.
It's not being a civil engineer or in the economics you can read about the budget, etc., that makes a difference. But there is something in him that he can do better, right? This afternoon. And then you need to improve. And again, I mentioned a lot of John because he was the last speaker. He said that he watched movies, he wants to improve so that he can play other roles. And somebody even said, maybe pastor, and he said you collect a lot of collections. And then you must have most of the talent that is in you, it's not for your use. All the people who have made it in life, you can read about them. They were serving. When they asked me, this, what is it? Apart from the passion, he says, I love writing programs. I'm sure Mr. Tickman loved what he did. Because when he started, he was so comfortable, and he said that I'm a ghostwriter. He's a ghostwriter. It's something that is out. It's someone who did economics, but look at where he finds himself. You must also decide it's not everything that you do for money. There are certain things like the self-entry. There are certain things that you can do to your child, and out of that, you get it. And what we are networking, we are doing so many things. You can pull somebody, you can, all the speakers that you can walk to them, and whatever you want to do, definitely you can get help. You can get help for your school, you can get help for your neighbors, your families, etc. The second thing is that between 18 to 25 years, profession, there's also another level. And that level is what most of the speakers spoke about. Your profession, your boss, your employer, your workplace, they will make available opportunities for you. And that's why this afternoon I will talk about opportunity briefly, how you will be able to take any opportunity that comes your way. But as you move along, from 55 to 75, you realize that the young man that you are talking about can be old. And that one, there is always little help. So the planning is now. Don't sit till I finish school or when I become a bank manager or when I become famous. No. Anything that you have to do, you must do it now. And when you grow old, you become even irrelevant, especially the society that we find ourselves. People don't appreciate old people. Now, I started by saying that there are three fundamental things that we need to know. The first one is operations. The operations means that your trade, your profession, your vocation, all of them spoke about it. And I'm sure that they know their staff. And you may know your staff after school. You may know how to handle your talent. It's very, very important. And I started the example of my legacy. We can all agree that the guy knows how to sleep. He did trailer, he did sleep. We can cite the example of John DeMello. We know that he knows how to act. He can slap my lead, he can also hold even less. Or Jewa. Not at all. Yeah, he knows how to hold Jewa. So operationally we say that John is fantastic. He knows himself. And because of that, he has been able to market himself. Mr. Tinkwan today said he knows what is right. He's telling us that there are professors that his degree is more than his name. But because he has something in him, the man will go on and sit with him and try to raise up for him. And he has written more than 40 books, like he said. So market-wise, he knows himself, he has been able to market himself. But the question is that when he gets the money, what happens? When John gets the money, must he always go to Barbados alone? Or go and cook somewhere? Have you ever sat down and asked yourself, when I get at the age of 60, what happens to me? And that is what SGRI Capital wants to address today. That lady, that farmer, when you are at the age of 60, what happens? Must you always work with the government sector before you get slave pension, dance and show? And this afternoon, the power is in your hands. And we are saying that there are more investment media that we can play on. And we are trained to help people to be able to. I don't want to go in. Maybe when the question comes, I may answer specifically. So maybe an investment decision can be made easier by seeking the services of investment advisor. I'm a trained investment banker, and when you come to our office or any of my people, and you want to know exactly where you can put your money, we will tell you what to do. The availability of investment advisors is to help you make the right financial and investment decision. And one of the things that we are doing today is to tell you how you can do this. But how do you even identify investment opportunity? Four things I want you to bear in mind. The first thing is that every investment opportunity must be attractive. It's a set. The guys, when you are going for a lady, you look at the color and look at, isn't it? Then you go after that lady. Or the ladies, you go after that. You see this guy, you see his mustache, like John, say, you're going a nice bow, you know. So every investment opportunity must be attractive. Don't do investment because you want to do investment. That's the key. The second thing is that you ask yourself, is it durable at all? Is it not? Are they not going to run away with my money? Can I continue to pay that amount continuously over time? It's very, very important. So don't just jump into anything, but ask yourself whether it's attractive, ask yourself whether it's durable, and then is it timely? Timely then means that will it serve your interest? I'm a first year student in a university, and I want to apply certain things after 4 years. So I decided to set up 20 Ghana cedis continuously for the next one. So that at the point where I graduated, I get my principal in interest. It's very, very important. And that's the kind of idea we want to sell to Success Africa. It is important that we now stop wasting time and waiting for a government or from government to come. It's like Tigran said a lot of things. And one striking thing is that he's looking for people with skills to employ. If I'm lying, say I'm lying. But that's what I hear. But he's not able to get you. And there are people who call and say, or meet, and say that we are forming unemployed graduates association. It's a shame. Because the university system is not meant for you to go and sit on government. It's just preparing you. And we were told that he did economics, but now he's doing something different. And everybody here has something new. It is the orientation. If you know your operations, if you know your marketing, how do you manage that kind of resources that comes in? And that's what I'm trying to tell you. To be timely, and it also add value. Value the way that we can make gains when it comes to investment. Please everything. Because you have a car somewhere. Else. Go! So that, you see, when you have an issue with a Ghanaian, he'll tell you, wait and you will see. Isn't it? But let's look at the Nigerian. That thing is in you. And I always cite Ghana blacks as an example when I'm talking about this. You see, most of them may have knowledge, most of them may have skills, but that attitude is also wrong, so we can never bring any car. How can you be a player be slapping your managers? Attitude is everything. So you need to understand that attitude, skills, knowledge, and networking don't come from school here and you come here, you cannot socialize. To somebody, just shake hands, and that's why I applaud the organizers of this program. It is important for us to know this. So how do we even invest? The first one is that you must set an objective. I mean, first year, like I said, I want to buy the latest car after 4 years. That's our objective. Then when you go to the investment advisor, he will tell you that start putting 20% so that in 4 years' time, both the principal and the interest that will accrue will help you by the time. I want to build a house. I want to have enough money so that even when I graduate and the national service money is not coming, I will still have my comfort. These are some of the objectives that we can set. And once you get objective or goal, you must, the investment advisor helps you to establish a policy. The policy will be the guidelines that you need to do. The policy is important for the understanding of both parties. And then you will select a strategy. The strategy depends on your risk level. Your risk level. So your risk level defines exactly what you whether you are risk averse, risk neutral, or I wanted to talk about this because we are not a microfinance, but we are rather an investment advisors, and we manage pension funds. Then this is what we do. We help people to put the ideas together to create work, move to the next. And this is our department. I wanted to talk briefly about this. This is a typical example. For example, this person makes one CD savings and go to the summary. Then you realize that if you save one CD for at least 25 years, you get about, we call it future, 70,000 Ghana. If you move for them and you go on retirement, you should be able to use this money to do it. These are some of the services that we render. For corporate finance, for asset management, for pensions, for business and investment advisory. I'm concluding by saying that as the man thinketh, so is. you want to be poor, it's here, you will be poor. If you want to get rich, you will get rich. If things are not affecting your thinking, then it will not affect your life. You must stretch a bit, like we were told. Investment requires attitude, skill, knowledge, and networking. Don't think of making money without planning, as planning implies strategic thinking. Everything on the face of the earth will start from a point. And on that note, I end here for any questions.
Hello. Nice question. We'll be for the investment class. You can ask all your questions there.
Guys, most of us, if you listen to the people talk to you, you realize that some of them are from very good homes, isn't it? They are from very, very good homes. You know, their fathers made it and they too. They are trying to leverage on that. For those of us who are not from so good a home in terms of riches, I have some message for you. We are told that the womb tomb is still so ahead. So that your children can be successful. Are you getting me? So I'm here to introduce to you the Chartered Institute of Marketing. This institute is the only body that awards Chartered Marketer Certificate. They can confer on you Chartered Marketer status. What it means is that whichever organization you go to, they believe that when it comes to marketing, you understand everything very well. I'm in a bank, I do cash management operations, ATM, but my qualification is that I'm a chartered marketer and I have MBA in project management. So you are here, you are reading other courses. If you are going to be smart, you can get another qualification before you complete your first degree. And that's the reason why I'm talking to you about marketing. You have so many people, you have ideas, want to build companies. But when you finish doing all that, how do you differentiate yourself from the lot? That is what marketing does. So I want to go on. So our body is the only body that will give you that certificate to make you a chartered marketer. This institute has been around since 1911. So it's very, very old. And it's from the UK. If you are interested and you join, you are going to be part of a worldwide community of professional marketers who will help you in whatever you do. There are a lot of softwares and portals around that. You go and you have any question on marketing, you get people 24/7 answering questions for you. So this is a leading international professional marketing body, and it's been around for a long time, as I said. All that we do is that the organization is the only organization that will make you certified marketer, so that wherever you go to with that certificate, people will be willing to work with you. Let's go to the next slide. Go to the next one, we don't have so much time. Okay, so we are asking you whether you know this. If you become a member of the institute, you are going to have access to what we call learning zone. When you go to the learning zone, anything about marketing, you have that information there. In Ghana, our education is said that you have some lecturers using 1925 lecture notes and teaching people of today. Meanwhile, things are evolving every day. The only thing that is constant is change. Things will continue changing. But when you join a professional body, whatever you are taught is related to what is happening in the industry. So you have practical things that you are going to know, and all that is available on our learning zone. You get practical insight. Now, if you want to talk about branding, last week, Thursday, we were with Papa Kasindo. Thursday, and he was talking about entrepreneurship. All that information that we get, we upload them. You can have online discussions, ask questions, get interactive. So We have online library where you can go and you get all the books in marketing. Then we have what we call chapter CBD program. I spoke to your excellency, I told them that if they want us to come here, we can organize a CBD program for you. CBD is continuous professional development. So you are learning, they are teaching you theories, but we bring people from the industry to come.